Jamai Topi, number 5. Ricardo Thomas, number 6. Javain Brown, number 14. Kevon Lambert, number 3. For a place in the second round are on 1 point, or Jamaica is on 1 point, and so the Jamaican team must win this afternoon to advance. For St. Kitts Nevis,
but they don't know what I feel. I'm going to capture me. I leave you, Nazi.
The starting lineup for the Jamaican team. They will start in goal with JD in white, number 1. Ajani Talbert, number 17. Jamoy Topi, number 5. Ricardo Thomas, number 6. Beckford, number 15. Alex Marshall, number 10. Nikhil Daly, number 16. And Tyree McGee, number 19. And we hope that they will leave here smiling after the Jamaican performance this afternoon. Once again, welcome to the Reggae Girls. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you now to rise for the playing of the national anthem. First, that of St. Kitts and Nevis, be followed by that of Jamaica. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, it's Jamaica going up against St. Kitts and Nevis for a place in the second round of the Olympic qualifiers.
Silence! right, nice. No, no, no!
Grazie. Yeah. Thank you.
Substitution for the St. Kitts and Nevis team. Out comes number 16, Xavier French. He's replaced by number 3, Youssef Saunders. So that's Youssef Saunders, number 3, in for number 16, Xavier French. Substitution 30.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah,
Ladies and gentlemen, the fourth official has indicated 5 minutes of added time minimum to be played if that's the end of the first half. So minimum 5 minutes. So the only goal coming in the 45th minute. So third minute of added time. So Jamaica 1, St. Kitts and Nevis 0. Goal scorer number 16, Nikki Daly. So that 45 plus 4. Jamaica scoring, Nikki Daly, number 16, the goal scorer. Jamaica 1, St. Kitts and Nevis 0.
Thank you.
for that the halftime whistle, and after 45 plus minutes of action, it's Jamaica needing to win but have the advantage up by 1-0 against St. Kitts and Nevis. Goal scorer number 16, Nikki Bailey.
Bring that.
Big side Jamaica.
Thank you.
Second substitution for St. Kitts and Nevis, coming in the 52nd minute. Number 10, Tyrese Chalet, out, replaced by number 11, Jair Hanley. So that's Jair Hanley, number 11, in for number 10, Tyrese Chalet. St. Kitts and Nevis, nil, Jamaica, 1. St. Kitts and Nevis finding the equalizer, unofficially in the 56th minute. Number 9, Giovanni Lee, the goal scorer, unofficially in the 56th minute. St. Kitts and Nevis 1, Jamaica One. That minute substitution there for Jamaica. Number 19, Derek McGee. He's replaced by number 18, Lamar Walker. So that's Walker number 18 in for number 19, McGee. Substitution in the 68th minute. Jamaica 1, then Kitson Nevis 1. Thank you. Substitution for Jamaica, saw number 3, Kevon Langer, coming out. He was replaced by number 12, Benton Evans. Number 12, Benton Evans, in, out number 3, Kevon Langer. 71st minute substitution for St. Kitts and Nevis. Goal scorer number 9, Giovanni Lake, is replaced by number 14, Taiwan Terrier. So that's Terrier, number 14 in. Number 9, Lake, come on, oh.
Thank you.
substitution for Jamaica, the third outcome captain, Alex Marshall, number 10, is replaced by number 11, Kyle Butler. So that's Kyle Butler, number 10, going number 11, going in for number 10, Alex Marshall. Substitution in the 77th minute. Both officials indicate minimum of 5 minutes added time to be played. So minimum 5 minutes added time to be played.
Thank you.
So that's the final whistle, and after 90 plus minutes of action, it's Jamaica 1, St. Kitts and Nevis 1. So, by virtue of this result, St. Kitts top in the zone with 4 points, while Jamaica finished second on 2. So St. Kitts and Nevis will advance to the second round of the Olympic qualifiers. Jamaica will have to fly again in another 4 years. So Jamaica 1, St. Kitts and Nevis 1. Congrats to the St. Kitts and Nevis team.
Disappointing end here to the Olympic qualifiers because Jamaica is out. But I mean, the team did everything possible. I mean, but tough luck, got the chances, couldn't put them away. I mean, but personally, where do you think it all went wrong for the team?
Well, in game one, we created 13 chances. Against Dominica, they created a half chance and the game was still 1-1. I think we were dismal in front of goal. In the first leg, it didn't happen for us, but we never played together for a long time, so I thought that was the icebreaker. When we went back and analyzed, we realized that even if we had won that game, we still would need to beat them in the last game based upon the goal differences. Dominica, they played against us in a deep block. They deliberately played to get a result from the game. They got a result, which was a drawn game. They opened up against St. Kitts because they needed to go 4 points 2 points wouldn't have helped them. So they conceded 4 goals. Having said that, the second game we watch St. Kitts, we analyzed, we did some background check on the team. Almost 2/3 of the team was based abroad. I keep on saying that we have to realize now, wake up and realize that football is not yesteryear when Jamaica and Trinidad and maybe Haiti was the dominant 3 teams. Now the teams are using their privileges that FIFA allows them to. The connection by relative, students that have left the country for years and still have heritage there. These are the players that they are using. They were playing 4-3-3. Today, they started 3 international players. They started a player that played in Mexico, 2 in England, 1 that plays in Leicester City's reserve team, was playing in the midfield. There were players from USL and the PDF Development League. So there were players from college also. So we knew that it was going to be tough for us. But what we knew is we knew their weaknesses. We knew our strengths. We played to our strengths today. You saw in the first half we were created about 3 to 4 chances. It didn't happen for us. We missed that easy sitter in the first 10 minutes of the game. We got the go-ahead goal. We spoke. We wanted to remain as a compact unit. They made a few changes. They threw everything at us. I thought they scored a brilliant goal. Nobody to blame. It was a solo effort by the player. We kept on pushing everything. We created more chance. We forced them back in a low block. We still wasn't clinical. And this is football. We have not lost in the 2-game competition. There's a lot of positive we can take out of the tournament still. It's a good experience for our guy. It's just unfortunate we still got eliminated by a team that eliminated us maybe 2 years ago at under 20 level. So it shows the program that they have. We still did enough to have won the game. It didn't happen for us. It's football. We understand these things. I would like to use your medium to apologize to the sponsors. That's important. Apologize to the people of Jamaica who have supported us. I take full responsibility for us not progressing. And this is life. We have to go back and analyze again. We have to look at what we did wrong, the things that we could have done better, and move on.
All right. Thanks. And I mean, can you just like briefly talk me through the second half? I mean, as you mentioned, in the first half, created a lot of chances, got the breakthrough towards the end of the first half. But in the second half, we saw like a different game where St. Kitts was more physical. They employed some time-wasting tactics. How much of an impact do you think that had on the game?
The second half was a contrast to the first half. The first half, they pressed us high up the field. As soon as they got the goal to draw a level, because all they needed was a result from the game, a drawn game. As soon as they got ball, they fall back in a deep block. So it was very frustrating for us. We did everything that we ought to do to break a deep block. We moved the ball a lot. We introduced Lamar Walker. He played a tremendous game. We broke their lines at will. We got in wide areas. We provided a lot of crosses. It didn't happen for us. We introduced Kyle Butler, which I thought was exceptionally good. He made a lot of quality forward passes. Unfortunately, he could have assisted DeShane Beckford to have gotten the second one. The game went on. They employed time-wasting tactics, and the time drifted. We did not, as I said, we were in clinical again. This is the game we created enough chance to have gotten on the score sheet again. And this is football. We accept this. And you don't lose. You learn. Once you stop, then you lose. But we will learn from this, analyze again, and hopefully the next time we'll definitely be stronger.
All right, great. And I mean, this isn't the end of the road as it relates to this summer for this group of players, because they have the Pan Am Games coming up. I mean, heading into that competition, what are your expectations and how will you be approaching that one?
Well, it would have been good if the Pan Am Games was before this tournament. We really wanted to play some games before together as a unit. It just didn't happen. It happened vice versa. Now we go off on Tuesday to the Pan Am game. It's important for us now. We are eliminated out of a World Global Tournament. That's another global tournament again. We can make a mark there. There's more experiences that we will garner as a national team, as an arm of the senior team. These are the guys who will matriculate in a few years into the senior team. So it's important for us to make use of those games. We want to be victorious there. We're not going there to participate. I thought we played two quality games in these two games that we are eliminated out of. I thought the guys left everything, and we want to matriculate that sort of performance over into the Pan American Games. So it's a tournament that we are still looking forward for.
All right, Coach. Thanks, and all the best in that competition.
Thank you very much, bro.
All right. All right, so Kyle, finally made a long-awaited debut for the national team here tonight, but result isn't what we'd want because, you know, we're out of contention for the Olympics. I mean, overall, how are you digesting all of this?
Right now I'm very disappointed, and it's not a good feeling to be knocked out so early, knowing that we have a quality team and also a quality coach. We're just unlucky for the two games to create numerous chances but didn't take them, and you know, that's football, you know. It's who scores the most that wins the game. It doesn't matter how beautiful you play or whatever, but you know. But I'm really happy to make my debut here in Jamaica and also in front of all my friends and family. So I was eager to play, and I hope I did my job.
Okay, and I mean, going forward from here, what are your hopes with the national team, you know, having now been introduced into the program?
My hopes for the national team is first to put in a proper structure within it. And for me personally, I would like to get my chance with the first team and show my quality there. And you know, but right now my focus now is with my club and my season there, so perform there. And you know, whenever the national team calls me up, I'll be there.
Coach, your team is through to the next round of the qualifiers and probably coming through not as favourites. I mean, came here, did a brilliant job. Can you just talk me through the range of emotions going through you and your team members right now?
Yeah, very emotional. But what I should first say, you shouldn't say... it's basically, we was not the favourite. Jamaica being always the favourite. From long, you know, the size. People tend to look at the size of the island and say, well, okay, then, yeah, Jamaica. And that's what I tell my guys. If we have to determine the game on the size of the country, then we wouldn't be here. Okay? Six weeks old team, you know? And the guys, them dedicated the time, and they said that they're coming to Jamaica to prove a point, basically, you know? I know it's kudos to Jamaica. They have a hell of a team. And that's how the game goes sometimes. You know, that's how we go sometimes, so, yeah.
All right, so go ahead. Tell me, how are you feeling about this accomplishment of progressing to the next round of qualifiers?
Well, firstly, I want to thank you for your compliment. I feel excited. I lost for words, to be honest. Work all year towards this. So it's just happy feeling. Guys going off the field with joy, with tears of joy. Hard work, results.
Okay, great. And you scored a brilliant goal yourself. Can you just talk me through that one? Solo effort. What was going through your head at the time?
Well, I think I like to fake people first, because I know the first reaction is to step in when I range up to shoot. So I cut it back on my right. Because they watched the last game, I see that I scored two goals on my left foot. So they feel like my left side is my strong side. But I cut it off my left, put it on my right, and I just slot it for a post. I was doing some early morning training. Two cones in the corner of the goal, and just hitting them.
All right.
So they had the early morning practice payoff.
All right, good. And moving forward now, the team has the next round of qualifiers to look forward to. How do you think you and the team will prepare going into that one?
We have the talent. As I said, hard work. We just got to go, put in more and more work, and we'll get there.